Choreb Beruach.
Sword of the Spirit. Interpreted and narrated by Wendy. BeRashit, Genesis, Chapter 38.
And it came to pass at that time that Jahudah went down from his brethren, and he turned in to a certain Adullami, whose name was Chirah. And there Jahudah saw a daughter of a Canaanite man, whose name was Shua, wealth. Then he took her and came unto her. Moreover, she conceived and birthed a son, and he called his name Ar. Then she conceived again and birthed a son, and she called his name Onan. Then she conceived again and birthed a son, and she called his name Shelach. And he was at Kizib when she bore him. Furthermore, Jehudah took a wife for Ar, his firstborn, whose name was Tamar. But Ar, Jehudah's firstborn, was wicked in the sight of Yehuah. So Yehuah slew him. Therefore Jehudah said to Aonan, "Go in unto your brother's wife, and marry her, and raise up seed for your brother." But Aonan knew that the seed would not be his. And it came to pass, when he went in unto his brother's wife, that he spilled it upon the ground, lest he would give seed to his brother. However, the thing which he did displeased Yehuah, therefore he slew him also. Then Jehudah said to Tamar, his daughter-in-law, "Remain a widow at your father's house until Shelach, my son, is grown." For he said, "Lest perhaps he die like his brethren also." Therefore Tamar went and dwelt in her father's house. And in the process of time, the daughter of Shua, Yehuda's wife, died. And Yehuda was consoled, and went up to his sheep shearers to Timnata, he and his friend Kira, the Adullami. Also it was told to Tamar, saying, "Behold, your father-in-law goes up to Timnata to shear his sheep." Therefore she took off her widow's garments from herself, and covered herself with a veil, and wrapped herself, and sat in an open place, which was by the way of Timnata. For she saw that Shelach was grown, and she was not given to him to wife. When Yehuda saw her, he thought she was a harlot, because she had covered her face. So he turned to her by the way, and said, "Go, I pray you, let me come unto you," for he did not know that she was his daughter-in-law. And she asked, "What will you give me, that you may come unto me?" Therefore he answered, "I will send you a kid from the flock." Then she asked, "Will you give me a pledge until you send it?" Therefore he asked, "What pledge should I give you?" And she replied, "Your signet, and your bracelets, and your staff that is in your hand." So he gave it to her. Therefore he came unto her, and she conceived by him. Then she arose and went away, and she removed the veil from herself, and put on the garments of her widowhood. Moreover, Yehuda sent the kid by the hand of his friend, the Adullami, to receive the pledge from the woman's hand. But he did not find her. Then he asked the mortals of that place, saying, "Where is the harlot who was openly by the wayside?" And they answered, "There is no harlot in this place." Therefore he returned to Yehuda and said, "I cannot find her." Also the mortals of the place said that there is no harlot in this place. So Yehuda said, "Let her take it unto herself, lest we become disgraced. Behold, I sent this kid, and you have not found her." Then it came to pass about 3 months later, it was told to Jahudah, saying, Tamar, your daughter-in-law, has played the harlot. Also, behold, she is with child by whoredom. Therefore Jahudah said, Bring her forth and let her be burned. When she was brought forth, she sent to her father-in-law, saying, I am with child by the man to whom these belong. Then she said, Discern, I pray you, whose are these? The signet, and bracelets, and staff. Then Jahudah recognized them and said, She has been more righteous than I, because I have not given her to Shalach, my son. And he did not know her again any more. And it came to pass, in the time of her travail, behold, twins were in her womb. While she travailed, then a hand came forth, and the midwife took and bound upon his hand a scarlet thread, saying, This came out first. And it came to pass, as he drew back his hand, behold, his brother came out. And she said, How have you broken forth? A breach is upon you. Therefore, his name was called Baretz, breach. And afterward his brother came out, who had the scarlet thread upon his hand, and his name was called Zerach,